Hi. In our today's video, we are going to be talking about the lambda probe. This is the lambda probe, or this is a modern O2 sensor. Why do we need this sensor? Well, as soon as our car is warm, then there is something that should be taking care of our ideal combustion. And one of those things is this sensor. Now, I'm going to tell you something just about this ideal combustion. In the laboratory conditions, it has been proven that the ideal combustion is achieved if the outside temperature is 20 degrees, if you mix 1 liter of fuel together with 10,000 liters of air, so we're talking about liters here, and if everything happens at the moisture of 1013 millibar, then our combustion is ideal. All of those parameters, guess what is measuring? So this sensor has to be in a good state. Many people don't know anything about them. Many people ask me if they have lambda probes. Well, if you have a catalytic converter, then you have a lambda for sure. Concerning this lambda, you have to replace it each 50k kilometers or 30,000 miles. That's pretty much about it, speaking about this sensor. If you ever experienced the situation that your car runs normal while warming up, and as soon as it is warm, then it starts stumbling, it starts jerking, it won't run as it has to run, your fuel consumption is suddenly high, then your idle is bad. Well, it's most likely that you have a bad lambda. So how do we check this lambda, if it is operational or not? Before showing you if it is bad or not, well, if you want to listen to my advice, because W124, 126, or all these cars with the lambda are about 30 years old, and they have some 200,000 kilometers on the clock, at least, even higher. As for mine, this is the original one, and it has been replaced at about 300k kilometers. If you want to listen to my advice, you don't even have to check this sensor if it is bad or not. I'm going to show you how it is checked. Well, if you have the mileage as I have, then I would recommend you strongly to simply to replace it. Don't bother yourself checking it. And as for Mercedes, always take the one from Bosch. You simply unscrew this part, On some models, you will see it at the engine compartment, and it will be about at the end of the exhaust manifold, or this one, mine for 230E, is screwed in the exhaust pipe. But never mind, what's important is that you read these numbers under Bosch. For my car, 0258003025. You see yours, and accordingly, according to this, you then buy the same one. Always buy a new one, don't buy the universal ones. Don't do that. Mercedes is very picky concerning the parts. Just give him respect by buying him the original parts from Bosch, and you will get that respect back. It's called multiple respect. So that's that's the theory. And now let's see how it looks in practice. How do you check your lambda probe? Let's see it, shall we? In order to simulate working conditions, I have my lambda here that we have to check. And you must know that the lambda starts operating when the engine is warm. So we need 80 degrees C. Here, I have boiling water, and now we are going to try to check these conditions. Okay, now let's presume that the car is on operating temperature. And now, in order to check your lambda, you must measure volts and the positive goes here into the signal and the negative goes onto the ground here. We practically don't have any fluctuation at all. So let's remind ourselves, in order for a lambda probe to be operational, it must fluctuate between 450 and 1000 millivolts. The closer to 450, the better. And let's try it here. Uh-huh. What's our fluctuation? Don't look at this lead. This is the connection for heating the lambda probe. Okay. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.